Intel's next-gen CPUs, we got details. Aliens is crashing the Pixel phones, and we find out why AMD was so scared to launch the 7800X 3D today. Let's get into the hot news, everybody. I'm your Brett host. We're gonna be going over the hottest tech news I can find on the internet while you enjoy your breakfast. Quick few reminders. Number one, we're giving away this PC right here, which has a 7950X and a 7900 XTX. In case you wanna win it, you can come watch us over on Twitch, which we are actually going to be doing a sponsored live stream where I should allegedly, at the moment that you're watching this, be getting ready to go into Micro Center to pick up a 7950X 3D, which we will then be putting into this PC right here to give away to you. So come watch, join all of that. Click the links in the video description to Micro Center, who's also sponsoring this episode of Hot News, and you can enjoy their great deals, the great deals of this PC we're giving away, and the great news of Hot News, which happens to be about Meteor Lake, 14th gen from Intel, and Z890 getting some details by some leakers indicating that Meteor Lake is kind of still on the fence about whether or not it's happening, but some details around Z890 showing that it's likely going to have roughly the same amount of PCI Express lanes, an additional four more from the chipset with 24 Gen 4 lanes total. It's going to introduce a Wi-Fi 7 and Meteor Lake. The CPUs are going to have slightly more PCI Express 5.0 PCI Express lanes because of an M.2 situation. Not going to have AVX 512 support, and the OS list says that it's going to support Windows 12, which hasn't even been announced yet, but it's likely that the Meteor Lake and Z890 situation is going to be on socket LGA 1851, especially since Intel only stays on a socket for two generations typically. So we're going to see a new socket introduced later this year, especially as the CEO of Intel has constantly said that Meteor Lake is on track for release later this year. However, there is some iffiness when it comes to the actual CPU. It's not quite clear what the flagship chip is going to be of the 14900K, with the leaker saying that the fastest chip that they know of is going to be 6P cores and 8E cores, which would only be 14 cores and a step down from not just the 13900K, but also the 12900K, saying that the 8P cores might also be under development. You add the 16E cores, and that does put you at the situation of the 13900K. Additionally, 6P core plus 16E core, giving you a 22 core situation. There's a whole lot going on there to break down. We'll obviously have to wait and see as more details are rolling out, but the details I want you to know about is today's video sponsor, Micro Center. My friends, today's video is sponsored by Micro Center. And February happens to be BYO, or build your own month, there because they've had tons of great deals for the entire month of February. So whether you're an experienced PC builder who's built hundreds or you're a first time shopper, Micro Center is there to help you with their knowledgeable associates and a wide range of PC parts to fit your build and budget. And they have their online PC builder where you can pick out your parts without having to worry about compatibility, and you can get it fast with Micro Center's 18-minute in-store pickup. And then if you don't want to go through the hassle of building it yourself, you can select same day pro assembly to have the Micro Center expert technicians assemble the PC for you in store. So whether you're experienced, you know what you're doing, Micro Center has it for you. And some of the great deals that they have are absolutely worth checking out, like this Ryzen 5 5600X plus B450M motherboard combo, where you're saving $45 when you bundle these together and getting a really solid start for your next gaming PC. And they want you to build, upgrade, and save with the ton of great deals that they have on their motherboard CPU combos, as well as other fantastic deals they have with over 30,000 items in stock. Absolutely love working with Micro Center. I finally got to visit one in person for the launch of the RTX 4090, and it was even better than I thought it was going to be, because we camped out overnight, we live streamed the whole thing, and the store manager brought us donuts and coffee to just celebrate the fact that we were waiting for a graphics card. It was like there was a community there by the store. It wasn't just like we were a nuisance waiting out trying to get this graphics card. It seemed like they really care, and that's thanks to the fact that they have a knowledgeable staff. They have an incredible selection, 25 stores across the United States, and tons of different parts. It's like a candy land for the PC enthusiast. And they also have a new customer exclusive coupon. New customers can receive a 256 gig SSD with the coupon in store only, no purchase necessary, a free SSD. And if you pair that with the motherboard CPU combo we talked about earlier, you're off to a great start for your next PC. So big thanks to Micro Center for sponsoring today's video. Work with their online PC builder. If you're a first time customer, get that coupon and check out their build your own deals at the link in the video description. I'm so thankful to be working with them. It's exciting. But you know what's not working with Pixel 7 or Pixel 7 Pro? Aliens. If you watch this specific HDR clip in 4K on the official YouTube app, it will take down your phone. No clear word on why this is happening. Just some weird bug that happens, like that picture that one time that was resetting all of those iPhones. It seems like it might also be happening on the previous generation phones, the 6, 6 Pro, and 6A. But in case you want to just reset your Pixel, go watch that HDR clip of aliens on your phone. And Reece has some more for you today. Give us the deals, buddy.
Yo, welcome back to UFD Deals, bringing the hottest tech deals out on the internet. Today's a special Micro Center edition. Britt asked me to look up a couple of deals ahead of time for him. I did exactly that, and they're too good not to share with you guys. First up, we have the CPU and motherboard combo with an Intel Core i7-12700K and an ASUS Z690A Prime. You can pick these two up for $378.98, which is $189.99 off. But then for an even bigger combo, we have the AMD Ryzen 9 7900X, ASUS B650EF ROG Strix Gaming Wi-Fi, a 32GB kit of G-Skill Flare X5 DDR5 RAM running at 6000 MHz. You can pick this entire combo up for $599.99, which is $276.97 off. And that's it, those are the deals. You can find the links to these and more in the video description down below. For all of those who have a Micro Center near you, I am jealous and I hope you enjoy it. But with that, I'm gonna hand you off back to Brett for the rest of your hot news. Cheers.
Thank you, friend. You know what deal you're not gonna find in Reese's UFD deals is a Chinese GPU, simply because they're not being released to the public very well. We've talked about the More Threads GPU, the MTT S80, finding out that while it was supposed to compete with more mid-tier GPUs like a 1660, in performance, sometimes it's not even beating a GT730. And we're finding out that there's another domestically produced graphics card coming out from China. The IDM 929 is supposed to be a GPU that's gonna have equivalent, at least teraflops performance, to the GTX 1650. Whether or not that's gonna actually hold true in gaming likely is not going to happen. It's gonna be built on a 14 nanometer node, which again is very similar, but one of the things that the Chinese domestic GPUs don't have is any sort of software support, any sort of codec support. That's one of the big issues with the MTT S80. DirectX 11, DirectX 12, that support's not being baked in. It's kind of the opposite problem of what Intel's having, where they support the latest stuff of DX 11 and 12, but then don't do 9. The MTT S80 is doing great on DX 9, but not on the relevant ones. We'll have to see how the IDM 929 does when it gets officially released, which is what's happening with the X3D chips. I'm picking up a 7950 X3D as long as they're stock. Again, come join us over on the Twitch stream, but the reviews for these chips came out yesterday, and it's essentially everything that we found out in AMD's reviewer's guide. It is faster than the 13900K in several games. It is slower in a few others. It's a really good value, high-end gaming processor. It is worse than the 7950X when it comes to just general day-to-day productivity tasks because of the 3D V-Cache slowing down the clock speed, making it so that it's worse in some situations. But also one of the things we found out is that in case you're gonna be running the 7900 or 7950X3D, you do have to install new chipset drivers because otherwise Windows doesn't know what the heck to do with these CPUs. So this chipset driver is a necessity for those higher end chips because it needs to figure out how to address whether the game is using the cores that have the 3D V-Cache or whether what application's going where on what CCD. It's a complicated scenario. So you have to actually pay attention to how you're setting up your PC. But when it comes to the 7800X3D, that's not gonna be the case because the cores and the V-Cache are all going to be on the same CCD, which has been the rumor that we've been hearing, that the 7800X3D is just gonna be better than the current chips that are actually releasing today because of not having the complications of having two different CCDs, but additionally potentially having a little bit more thermal headroom because it's not gonna have so many cores. So potentially those CCD cores could run a little bit faster, the gaming could be a little bit better, and wouldn't you know, it was found out that's exactly what happens if you take a 7950X3D and you cut it in half and you kind of tweak it to make it match a 7800X3D, it's a much better value. So Tech Power Up has an entire written article. We'll leave a link in the video description in case you want to check it out. But them showing off that the 7800X3D reaches performance better than the 7950X3D, and it beats the 13900K, and it's only going to cost $450 as opposed to the $570 for the 13900K and the near $700 that AMD is charging for the 7950X3D, the CPU that it looks like you should wait for is going to be this 8-core 7800X3D. Also them finding out that the power consumption, way better on the simulated 7800X3D, only 44 watts when the 13900K was taking 143 watts. So just a great chip overall, better performance, better power efficiency, cheaper price. How do you go wrong? No wonder they're launching it in April. Why would you buy the 7950X3D and the 7900X3D? It's, you're cutting down the multi-core performance in order to get better gaming. But if you just want better gaming, then just buy the 7800X3D at the price point that it exists at. But if you want that better multi-core performance, why wouldn't you just get the 7950X or even the 13900K, which is going to give you similar gaming performance, but then much better productivity thanks to the fact that it has 24 cores. AMD put themselves in a really weird situation by launching these 12 and 16 core CPUs at the price point that they did, and kinda not keeping to their word by changing the date that they released it at. The 7800X3D, they made no caveats when they announced that it was coming out in February, and now we have to wait till April. I understand it from a business decision. I think it's pretty clear why they didn't wanna give it to you right now, because then they just have these high-end chips that are sitting on shelves. And I'm not sitting on a shelf, I'm live streaming right now over on Twitch. Come watch us. Watch us pick up one of these chips that you don't need to buy, but we're gonna give you. Again, big thanks to Micro Center for making it all happen. Guys, if you check out Micro Center, you click the links, you buy the stuff from them, we can continue to do more stuff like this. It's great. I love this partnership. Keep going.